Well, hello, and welcome to the first edition of a reading from The Buzz at Chicky-Pie's Cafe, my first fiction novel for adults. I'm going to begin with chapter one, but I'm not going to read it all, so listen up. It were in 1965 when my mama, Millie, first opened my place. She noticed we had potential to be a different kind of cafe, and saw that things could be something special round here. She helped that special spirit to grow more by giving me encouragement and knocking down some of my old walls of trouble and bias. She also gave me pretty new colors that made me feel good about myself. She even painted my door bright yellow. She say it's a happy color. That was in the beginning, but that ain't all there is to know about things at Chicky-Pie's. So keep on coming by and see if you find some good folks and some good food too. Food for the soul. 2007, Elise. Shivers swept up and down my arms, yet a hot blanket of fear weighed heavy on me. I thrust it aside. Whispers outside my door faded like a vaporous mist, and I slowly opened the door. I peered down an empty hallway, looking for something or someone. I wasn't sure what. Darkness enveloped me, and the air hung stale, suffocating. I inhaled frantically. A foul, metallic taste lingered in my mouth. Shadowy figures flickered by, and I ventured out of my room. Heart racing, I stumbled towards an exit door and jiggled the doorknob. Locked! Gasping for air, I turned with dizzying speed as a guttural sound escaped my throat. A parked car sat empty outside the window to my left. The front passenger door was wide open in invitation. I have to get out. To my right, another hallway appeared and a door left ajar at its end. I lunged forward, peering out the window. A second car waited, engine running, no driver in sight. I stopped mid-step, breath catching in my throat. It was the perfect opportunity for escape. Too perfect. A clock began ticking. I've got to get out of here. Tick. Tick, tick. A swarm of bees swooped in through an open window. Buzz, buzz, buzz. I jolted awake. Gasping for real this time, I took a moment for my heart and my breath to steady. Buzz, buzz, buzz. The blaring noise repeated. I slammed the top of my alarm clock. Deafening silence replaced the angry hum. My face and neck were moist with perspiration, and my body felt cold and clammy. I tried to rise, but my head fell heavily onto my pillow. My heart was racing, my mind grasping for reality, and my eyes begging for more rest. The dream had dredged up frantic emotions I tried to stuff within. A trail of lingering questions pleaded for answers, demanding resolution. It's up to me, I said out loud, as if my audible command would make a difference. God, please help me, I whispered desperately to the ceiling. A deep impression marked my spirit, a premonition. I have to get out now, but how? Discouragement settled in. God, are you even real? If he was, I imagined him a stern old man, looking down from the sky, watching us flail about in misery. That's how God felt to me anyway. So maybe my ideas about God are distorted mirages, skewed by my experiences and not based on truth. I let out a deep sigh. Finally getting up, I poked my cold feet into slippers and pulled a robe over my chilly goose bump body. Making my way down to the bathroom, a heaviness clung tightly to each step. The whapping noise of my slippers hitting the heels of my feet amplified on the wood floor. sounds reminiscent of the abuse I'd taken over the years. All the slapping and whapping and whoring a child can unwittingly submit to without dying. Was it my imagination, or was the dream a warning? Whatever it meant, I would have to find out alone. I had no one. How would I ever escape without help? I took another steadying breath and thought, okay, God, I'll take a chance. If you're there, I need you. That's all for now. Come back again for another taste of honey from the Buzz at Chicky Pie's Cafe. Bye-bye.